bounty. Find my family, please.
That's actually one of the few vertical elements in the whole game. Hold on.
No one will be there.
Baby and me! Baby and me!
Plasmids changed everything. They destroyed our bodies, our minds. We couldn't handle it. Best friends butchering one another. Babies strangled in cribs. The whole city went to hell.
So, you know, introducing again the idea that the plasmids mess people up. What was I saying earlier? Oh yeah, you were put in the elevator. And then you were shown this building as the elevator went up and Atlas talked to you and told you his story. You're supposed to save his family and all that, so you know, everything's being paced out slowly and you're being told what's happening and what to do. What is this? This is a... oh, Kashmir restaurant, that's right. Kashmir restaurant.
I'll do what I want! It's my Adam! I earned it!
You want this, ugly? Or do you want this nice? I can do it either way.
What's the big idea, darling? Charlie! Charlie, where are you going? No, Charlie!
Yeah, so you might notice I'm not very good at this yet. I'm a bit rusty. Hopefully I won't fail too much. Where's a gun? Huh. Anyway, so yeah, the game will almost commentate itself. You can tell there's a lot of chatter. And they talk back and forth a lot. Happy New Year. So 4659. So that, what was that? 13 years? From when they started building it to when it fell apart. Anyway, I'm just back here looting stuff. So don't mind me. And yep, that's just everything.
If you spot a splicer in the water, hit him with the electrobolt.
So there you're being introduced to the idea of using electricity and water. Leadhead splicer, you should have a gun on him. But I don't see it. Huh. And obviously there's these diaries, which again, the game pretty much tells you the story.
Another New Year's, another night alone. I'm out and you're stuck in Hephaestus, working. Huh. Imagine my surprise. Well, just guess I'll have another drink. Here's a toast to Diane McClintock, silliest girl in Rapture. Silly enough to fall in love with Andrew Ryan. Silly enough. What's happening?
So, yep. Voice recordings, I guess that's when Rapture first got messed up. AccuVox. Recording the thoughts and lives of Rapture citizens for 5 years and counting. Fontaine futuristics for the city of the future. You know, the game does a very good job. Wow. The game does a very good job of telling the story. And I really do need more ammo. Money, first aid. I need all of this since I'm playing on difficult.
Too spiced up. I'm too spiced up. Nobody's gonna want me.
Hey Brenda, you care to tell me why you had a hole in the wall the size of Plymouth Rock coming out of your crapper going on 3 weeks now? Now, I ain't saying I'm Shakespeare, I'm trying to run a respectable theater. I got working folk coming in from Port Neptune trying to catch a little diversion. And all they can think about is the stink coming out of your shitter. Get it fixed.
So there's a whole tape talking about the hole in the toilet, which is here. I mean, a lot of it is just flavor.
Careful. That's a child down there. Don't be fooled. She's a little sister now. Somebody went and turned a sweet baby girl into a monster. Whatever you thought about right and wrong on the surface, well, that don't count for much down in Rapture. Those little sisters, they carry Adam. The genetic material that keeps the wheels of Rapture turning. Everybody wants it, everybody needs it.
And you can see how they force you to walk over here in order for you to see the little sister, like all this debris here, to stop you from taking a route that will lead you away from what they want you to see. And you see there the spotlight on the little sister and on the door. So there's a lot of theatrics going on. There's a lot of setting up scenes for you to see things. And as we come down here, we'll see a bit more of that. So yeah, as he says, there's the Big Daddy. And it's almost like a cutscene, except it's in the game itself. And this gate was locked, so you couldn't get out, so you kinda had to see that. And you had to come down the stairs. By the way, you can't go back out. So you had to come down, and you had to turn this way because there's nothing here. And then they show you that scene, and then they let you keep going. Everything is set up to make sure you see things that they want you to see. And then they show you all the different ideas of the game and they introduce you to all the different elements. Which is a very good thing, considering that this is the introduction to the game, the first area. But, you know, having said that, if we look at the map, it's all really just corridors and rooms. I mean, you can see rooms and corridors. I guess the Kashmir restaurant had two levels, and you can go in the kitchen and come back out, so there's a little bit of exploration there. And then after that, it's all linear. And again, I mean, it's an introduction to the game, so you don't want to make it too complicated for the players.
Call the cops on me!
But yeah, everything's quite linear at this point. And you know, the game itself is, I guess there's, overall it's linear, but within that there's some freedom to walk around and then do other stuff. I guess we'll talk about that when we get to it. And this is the first serious combat area, or the first set piece, I guess you would call it. And interestingly, up here you get a good view of it. You know, you can look down at it, you can see the enemies there. You can see water, and then you see the room. So, you know, like any good puzzle design, they show you the puzzle before asking you to have to solve it. So, you know, you walk all the way around, and all of this is glass, so you see the whole room, and you see everything that's ahead of you. And then once we're done with that, you come in. That door is closed, that door is open. What does that say? Neptune's bounty is that way. Let's see what's in here. I don't want the alcohol. And I don't think there's anything in the toilet area. Oh wait, what's this? Bandages. There's a first aid kit in here, keep that in mind in case we need it. Because...
Security alert in progress.
Because of that. So this is the set piece. So you know the water's there.
Are you afraid of me, monster?
And I have played this game before, and so I know what's going on.
You call that gratitude?
Okay, that could have gone better, but it wasn't too bad. I need more ammo. Did anyone else drop anything? No, she's a thuggish splicer, that's a flamethrower. Nothing there. Are there guns in here? No, no. Alright, well, we'll keep going. So this is a, yeah, I mean, talking about set pieces, basically, if you don't know what that means, it means a, it's like a scripted moment. A scripted, highly theatrical moment where you have to do a particular thing to get through it, and you know, these are actual gates in the game, like they're metal gates, but in game design they're also called gates, even if they're not actual gates like this, which is, you know, they close you into an area and you have to do a certain thing before the gate will open and let you through to the next area of the game. So that's a see, that's another gate. Obviously it's a metal gate, but it's also a gate in the game. There, it closes, you can't move.
Oh Christ! You're trapped! I'm gonna try to override the exit from here!
So this is almost like game design 101.
So tell me, friend, which one of the bitches sent you? The KGB wolf or the CIA jackal? Here's the news. Rapture isn't some sunken ship for you to plunder. And Anne Ryan isn't a giddy socialite who can be slapped around by government muscle. And with that, farewell. Or Bus Vavania, Germany.
So you see that Andrew Ryan is a little bit paranoid. So you were never actually in any real danger there. But the game made it seem like it's really urgent and that, you know, you should panic a bit. And they forced you into that room and made you wait a little bit, made you feel like you were trapped, and then they opened the door and then you threw. So everything's scripted and everything is designed for a particular effect. And I think I'll end that segment there. I mean, I think that's a... You know, if I ever have to teach a class about game design, I might just use that as a case study, because that's actually quite well done as an introduction to a game. Like, it tells you all of the concepts of the game. Well, not all of them, but most of the basic concepts of the game, the basic story behind the game, and then it makes use of the gates and the set pieces and showing you the puzzle, you know, in that glass corridor, and giving you weapons. Like, first it gives you a crowbar, then it gives you the what is it? The electro bolt, and then it gives you the gun. So it's giving you bits and pieces, one after the other, and then asking you to use them and get used to them. And then finally giving you that challenge. So it's all very well set up. And you can, you know, just from that you can tell that there's some very good game designers. And a lot of very smart people working on this thing. And of course there's all the artwork and all the attention to detail that they put in, and they obviously spared no expense to make everything awesome. Alright, I'll end this bit here. Next bit is the medical pavilion. So it's... I guess we should count that introduction as the tutorial. So now we get some serious gameplay. A little bit. I'll see you guys in a bit.